Here are today's top tech stories. The Philippines SEC is proceeding to block access to Binance, labeling it as a threat to investor funds after securing approval to remove its local website access. And although the total number of Filipino Binance users remains unknown, crypto news publication Coin Journal estimates that there was around 7 million crypto owners in the Philippines as of February last year, representing roughly 6.1% of the population. Crowd Credit from Japan and Singapore's Helicap are partnering to invest $50 million in Southeast Asian firms connecting Japanese investors with opportunities in the region for stable returns. And Annexed Bank, based in Singapore, has secured a $148 million investment from Ant Group, raising its total investment from the parent company to over $503 million. And Spacely AI is a startup that is offering AI-powered interior designer tools. Very cool. They just raised pre-seed funding from SCB 10X. It has partnered with Index Living Mall and Proud Real Estate, designing space for over 120,000 users worldwide. And its very versatile tools actually allow users to create or update spaces very easily, generating design suggestions from uploaded photos alone for both complete redesigns and minor additions. That seems like a total game changer in the interior design world. And Apple looks like it's in early talks with Baidu to possibly integrate Baidu's generative AI technology into its products in China, aiming to boost AI features once again and adhere to local regulations. Partnering with Baidu could help Apple navigate the complexities of the Chinese market and language, although discussions are ongoing and it is uncertain if other Chinese AI firms have also been approached. And finally, amid discussions of a US ban on TikTok unless it divests from ByteDance, the company's founder, Zhang Yiming, opposes a sale. A recent US House bill proposes a 180-day deadline for TikTok to separate from ByteDance or leave the US market, pending US Senate approval. And in our guest post for today, we have Jeremy Tan, who's talking about bubbles, booms, and busts in the market as a result of imbalance. He uses a very interesting analogy to make it sound a little bit easier to understand. He says it's like one of those old dual twisty shower taps that you see in hotels. There's hot and there's cold, but it's always very difficult to get the right temperature. And he says that the way that the economy functions is not that dissimilar. You can read the rest of the article, it's up on our website. Thanks for watching today's top tech news. If you enjoyed this, please make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel or give us a follow on our TikTok account.